Hi, and welcome back to myExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over some basics with custom number formatting in Microsoft Excel. So by the end of this video, we want to show you how you can have a number like we have here in A2 and display more decimal places like we have here in B2.
Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that.
So right now I can see that the numbers I have here in A2 and B2 are the same number. Just the one in B2 has more decimal places than the one in A2. So if I click in A2 and I wanted it to look like B2, I have a couple of different options. You see how I have 4 trailing zeros right here, but I have none right here? Well, the first way I can get A2 to look like B2 is to go up here on the home ribbon and over here to the number group. And I can decrease my decimals here, or I can increase them here. So I'm just going to hit this 4 times, and you can now see that these two look the same. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. I can also do this through custom number formatting. So let's say I don't want these zeros. I always want to have only one digit after the decimal. If I go over here and go down to more number formats and go to custom, up here I'm going to type 0.0. And so the zeros here will always display a number. And it will always display a number only to the decimal place that I have indicated here. So this is one decimal place, this is 2, this is 3. But for now, let's just have 1 after the decimal. And then I'm going to click OK. And now I can see that my number of decimal places is less. But if I go back up here and I go down to more number formats and go back to custom, I have an option to use a pound sign instead of a zero. So if I put pound.0 in here for my custom format, and then I go to OK, you can see that the leading zero disappears because there isn't a number there to represent. So if I wanted to force the leading zero, I would do 0.0 for the format, but if I wanted to leave it optional, then I would do pound.0. So when I put 1.5 in here, it's going to retain the 1. But if I go back here and just put 0.5, it's not going to give a leading zero. So the pound sign makes putting a number in the format optional, whereas a zero forces a number to go there, even if it is 0. Now there's more to custom formatting, and we go into this a lot more in detail out on our blog. And I'm going to include a link to that blog entry in the description below on YouTube if you would like to go there and learn more. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them for us and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching, and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.